Martha was an average dog. She went and but when she ate some alphabet soup, then what happened was bizarre.
On the way to Martha's stomach, the letters lost their way. They traveled to her brain, and now
she's got a lot to say. Now she speaks.
How now, brown cow?
Martha speaks. Yeah, she speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks.
What's a caboose? What are we eating again?
Martha speaks.
Hey, Joe, what do you know?
My name's not Joe.
She's not always right, but still that Martha speaks.
Hi there.
She's got her voice. She's ready to shout. Martha will tell you what it's all about. Sometimes wrong, but seldom in doubt. Martha will tell you what it's all about. That dog's unique.
Testing, 1, 2.
Hear her speak. Martha speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and
communicates, enumerates, elucidates, exaggerates, indicates, and explicates, bloviates, and overstates, and hyperventilates.
Martha, to reiterate, Martha speaks.
Come on, just one spoonful. Isn't this fun?
Hey! Morning, world!
It's Martha. She's fun. You can play with her when you finish eating. Here you go.
That's right. Finish your food, Jakey, and we can play. Darn ditchy ear!
Martha, would you mind scratching somewhere else?
That wouldn't work. It's my ear that itches.
No, I mean, could you take your ear somewhere else and scratch it?
Oh, sorry.
Martha, can you scratch someplace else?
I tried to explain to Dad, if
I mean another room.
Right.
Martha.
It's the middle of the night.
Sorry, it's just his ear.
What's the problem?
I wish I knew. It really itches. Oh! Oops.
Looks like it's time for a trip to the vet.
Well, it's nothing serious. Just a case of ear mites. These drops should take care of them. Meanwhile, we have to devise something to keep you from scratching that ear, young lady.
Devise?
Devise means to come up with something to fix our problem. For instance, a secret agent might devise a way to talk to his boss by having a phone in his pen.
Cool. Do I get one?
No, you get a cone on your head.
Everything sounds really weird. Hey, I sound like a radio announcer. Hello? Hello, this is Martha coming to you on station... Ow.
Uh-oh. Are you okay?
Yeah, I guess I'm not used to how wide I am. Ow. Ow.
Sniffing.
I have to wear it for a week or two. It's a contraption that's supposed to keep me from scratching. Oh, a contraption. It just means a gadget or a device that's made for a special job. In my case, to keep me from scratching. Yes, like a phone in a pen. Now, any more questions? If not, I'm trying to nap here.
Good baby, Jakey. Yum,
yum. Oh, boy, did I not sleep well. I kept thinking I heard a bear breathing.
I don't know.
What?
Martha, I think your cone is scaring Jake.
It is?
It's just me, Jakey. Martha, maybe you should go out of the kitchen, at least until he's finished eating.
I've got it, Jakey! Here I come!
Martha, I think it's a good idea if you stay away from Jakey, at least for a while.
Shh, it's okay, Jakey.
I hate this stinking contraption. Bad cone. I hate you.
Oh, life is so unfair.
Hey, Martha, how's it going?
This cone is driving me crazy. I keep scaring Jake and running into things.
Oh, I know someone who could help you with that.
You do?
Who? Let's go see my dad.
Whoop! Whoop! Whoop!
Almost.
Whoop! 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 Whoop!
That's it!
Whoop! I did it! I learned my first word in dog. Did you hear that?
I heard, OG. I heard.
Woof! Wow! Maybe next year I'll speak only in dog. The whole year, nothing but woof and arf. What do you think?
That's a great idea.
Teach me another word.
Dad, don't forget, we have to help Martha with the cone.
Oh, of course. Come on, do the workshop!
You made all these things?
That's right. All these gadgets are my inventions. Inventions, in case you didn't know, my fine furry friend, are things that someone makes to fill a need. Like this. It's a gadget I devised for barbers. You can see what you look like with a haircut. Or if you let it grow.
Wow.
Over here are some other inventions I've devised. This one's a sandwich with printing on it, in case you feel like reading in the cafeteria. And this one is a book you can eat in case you get hungry in the library. Try it.
Mmm, delicious. What's this machine do?
Huh?
I said, what does this machine do?
I don't know, but it sure is loud.
Those are all great inventions, OG. But do you think you can create something for me?
Of course, but first things first. Before we invent something new, we have to know the problem we're trying to solve. Hey, look, I'm a lamp. You know, this is not a bad gadget, this cone. Okay, I see the problem.
I'm kind of getting used to running into things, but I just can't get used to having Jake be afraid of me.
We just have to devise something that looks less scary to a baby. We need a variation on a cone.
A variation?
Yeah, sure. A variation is kind of the same thing, but with little changes. I know. Now that should keep you from scratching. And you can see your whole head. It looks like a space helmet.
I think she's trying to say something.
Can't breathe.
That could be a definite problem. Looks like we need to think up a variation on this helmet.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
That helmet scares me. What's it gonna do to a baby?
You have a point. We need to design a simpler variation. Time to go back to the basics. What do children like? I know.
Hi, Jakey.
It's me, Martha.
It's okay. I'm going. Oh, it's no use. No matter how many variations we invent, I still look like I'm a spaceman or an alien. I should just go hide under the porch, except I'll probably get stuck halfway.
Wait a minute. Maybe you're on to something.
No, TD, I'm not. Trust me.
Martha, I've got an idea. This'll be great! Whoa! I'll be back!
Why do I have a feeling this is a bad idea?
Martha, you can't live in the basement. Don't be silly.
But I don't want Jake to be afraid. I'll just stay down there until the cone comes off. That way he'll never have to see me.
I don't think that'll be necessary. I've devised a solution to all of your problems. Guaranteed.
book. How is a book supposed to help me?
It's not for you. TD has a story for you, Jakey.
Don't look at me like that. You're going to love it. It's about Martha. It's called Space Dog Martha.
Let's hear it.
Space Dog Martha and Dr. Jake are going to the moon. A space dog needs a special helmet. It looks like a comb. That's right, Jakey. It's Martha. 3, 2, 1, blast off! Zip zoom, we're going to the moon! Hooray! We made it!
Moon!
But what's this? All of a sudden, the moon cracks open. It turns out it's not the real moon. It's a fake moon put up by the evil inventor, Dr. Arms. Inside is a giant contraption he devised, the Tinkabath 5000!
Tabitha?
That's right. It's a machine with a giant water tank for a body, 8 shower hose arms, and a soap dispenser for a head.
Ha, ha, ha! Bath time, you two!
A bath? Try and get us! And with that, Dr. Jake and Space Dog Martha leap into action, running in crazy figure eights until the robotic contraption is tied into a giant knot, along with Dr. Arms. Good thinking, team. Hang on to my cone, Jake. And with that, we fly all the way back home, just in time for bed. Good night. The end.
Did you like it, Jakey?
That!
It worked.
TD, that was a great idea.
You did it! Thanks!
Oh, choking, Jake. Not so hard, buddy. Okay, thanks.
TD, maybe you better read it again.
So, cuántos? How many?
19.
Same here, but that's only because everybody in our class had to give a Valentine to everyone else.
I got 28.
There's someone who got us all beat.
Who?
Courageous collie Carlo. He's so dreamy.
What does it say?
Martha, you're the hound of my heart. Will you be my Valentine? It's from Alice.
Wow, Martha, you're really popular.
Skit's got one more than me, but that's because I sent him one. In a minute, Skits.
See, but do either of you have one that sings?
Carolina, be my Valentina. Nothing could be finer to me.
It sounds like your voice.
Well, if you don't send a singing Valentine to yourself, who will?
Good point.
Carolina, be my Valentina. Nothing
Hang
could
on,
be
Skits.
Finer to me.
I really have to admire how much thought I put into designing this card. It's really original.
I'll admit it's original. Mine are pretty boring. I got way too many ones with the same illustration of a pickle that says, "You mean a great dill to me."
Yeah! I think everyone just buys the same box. They don't bother to personalize them.
Oh, I can make you a personalized Valentine. It'll be exquisite. Exquisita.
Exquisite? You mean you can squeeze it and it squirts?
No, exquisite means something's really, really beautiful. I'm going to start designing it right away.
I'd rather have one that squirts.
Hey, can someone throw Skits some snowballs? I'd do it, but no thumbs. Speaking of which, open that one.
It says, canine be mine.
I drew that one.
Aw, thanks, TD.
Ready, Skits?
Hey, maybe I could draw some more Valentines, too. Is there any paper I could use?
Up in my room.
Come on, Drew, let's make some Valentines.
Wait for me. Sorry, Skits. Ready?
I can't find my eraser. I just had it.
Did you check under the table? Sometimes stuff bounces under the bench.
Don't look! You can't look!
I'm not gonna copy you. I just need a place to draw.
Ew, glitter!
Found it! Go work in the other room. This is top secret.
It's no good if it's not a surprise. Oh, this is going to be exquisite. Now, shoo you, you can't look yet. You can't look either.
Boy, you sure have a lot of art supplies. I can really create something completely original. What's that?
Just some materials for crafts, scraps of fabric. I'm gonna use them to decorate my valentines.
Oh.
Personalized? You mean they're just for persons, not dogs?
No, personalized means that you make something special for someone. Like that valentine I made for you in the shape of a bone.
Glitter pen!
Did you take my glitter pen?
Why would I want your glitter pen?
Is there a problem?
Carolina can't find her pen.
Did you pick it up when you were in the kitchen?
Me? No. I think I might have one upstairs.
Did you see it? On her hand! Glitter!
She probably just got it when she was looking under the table. You have like a major sandstorm of glitter in there. It's like you're decorating the whole kitchen.
I wish I could be sure.
Your pen is probably under the table. Let's go look.
Excuse me a sec. Can't decide what to do?
Well, it's important to have the design just right. Design means you plan the way it's going to be, right down to the last detail, before you start creating it.
Right. I thought I had a glitter pen here.
Helen?
Yeah?
Help me, I don't know what to do.
Huh?
I can't do this, I can't.
Truman, it's just a valentine.
Everyone says it's just a valentine, but that's just to cover up the fact that it's really crafts. It's crafts, isn't it? Admit it.
Yeah? Come on, it's fun. You can use cloth or beads or any materials you want to decorate it.
That's crafts. That's the dictionary definition of crafts. Crafts are things people make themselves, by hand.
But what's the matter with crafts?
I'm going to tell you something that I've never told anyone else. It happened when I was in kindergarten.
That's an exquisite lion, Cindy. Oh, Truman, it's crafts time, not nap time. Head off the table, please.
Yeah, I wish I could.
How does anyone pace themselves to a table?
I don't know. Ow, take it easy. TV's gonna make really funny ones. You're gonna make something really exquisite out of cloth. Carolina's going to decorate hers with glitter. Okay, those will be tacky. But what about me? What will I have? A pair of scissors glued to my head. Why did I ever agree to do this? I can't take it, I tell you. I can't take the pressure.
Just draw something. You like drawing, right? Here, have a candy heart.
Thanks.
I'm telling you, right on her hand! Glitter!
There's a ton of glitter under here, but no glitter pen.
What are you looking for?
Ow!
Nothing.
Just playing with skits, right, boy?
I couldn't find another glitter pen.
Okay, sure. I can't believe it! Here I was making this absolutely exquisite valentine about how wonderful she is, while she's busy taking my pens.
That can't be right. Helen wouldn't take anything. She's probably just...
Gay. What?
My school notebook! It was right here. It had all my important stuff in it.
Someone stole your homework?
No, important stuff. My sketches for valentines, my pirate name ideas, my old gum, everything!
Has anyone seen my fabric?
Fabric? No.
Something weird is going on.
Everyone's art materials are missing. Maybe it's time to have a look around.
To face facts.
We're dealing with someone who will stop at nothing, not even taking other people's art supplies, to keep them from making Valentines.
Skids, what is it? He has something he wants to show us. Quick!
Oh.
What? What is it?
He wants us to throw more snowballs.
Skits, we don't have the time right now. It's okay. We'll play just as soon as the mystery is solved.
What's this?
Someone left a Valentine.
You stole my heart.
Aww.
And TD's notebook, and Carolina's glitter pen, and Helen's fap... Hey, who wrote this?
Don't look at me.
Carolina, this looks like your handwriting.
Okay, I wrote it. I thought it would make whoever took our supplies confess.
Okay, nobody leaves this room. We'll get to the bottom of this.
You don't get to say nobody leaves this room. I get to say nobody leaves this room.
Why do you get to say nobody leaves this room?
Because I didn't steal the art supplies.
You're saying I did?
I don't have to say. Our parents will.
Parents?
You sound nervous.
Oh, come on. Can't you make nice personalized cards without fancy glitter pens or fabric?
Yeah, but you can't do it without trusting the person.
What are you saying?
Can I trust you? I know who did it.
You do?
Who?
Let's go into the living room. All right, everyone. Now, the first question is, why would someone want to steal your supplies?
Someone who hates art supplies.
Mm-hmm. And what did they steal from you, TD?
Oh, right. My notebook.
But we were all in the kitchen when that happened. Everyone except Truman. Truman? Where were you?
Right here, looking at TD's notebook. I thought I might get some ideas to help me overcome my nervousness about crafts.
So it was you who took my notebook. I want it back.
I didn't take it. Why would I take it?
You wouldn't. And Truman was nowhere near your glitter pen. Was he, Carolina? Well, now that you mention it, no.
Why do you think someone was stealing the stuff, Martha?
Truman, will you look under that cushion, please?
It's there!
It's all there!
Wow! Martha, you did it! You solved it!
So which one of us did it?
It was the only one who had both the motive and the opportunity. Plus, he's the one who always hides things under that cushion.
Ew, slobber!
Skits? You hid all our supplies?
Burr.
It's not his fault. He was just jealous of all the attention you were giving the Valentines.
Oh, poor Skits. He felt left out.
It's okay, Skits. We're not mad.
Hey, who wants to go throw snowballs for Skits?
Let's go!
Yeah!
Here, Skits. Catch!
I'm gonna create a ginormous, personalized snowball to heave at someone.